Satan's greatest trick was convincing man he didn't exist.
And if there's one thing I know, you can't control evil. You can lock it up, you can burn it and bury it and pray that it dies, but it never will. It just rests a while. You can lock your doors and say your prayers at night, but the evil's out there, waiting. Maybe. Just maybe. It's closer than you think.
This is George Washington. In the last century, they decided they didn't have a decent statue of George, so instead of getting an American to produce one, they ordered it from Italy, from Florence. And when it arrived on the dockside, people were staggered, because here was George, the first president of the United States, depicted naked from the waist up, with his cloth over his Bill Clinton's, and then pointing up one arm, pointing down the other. What's going on? Unless you realize where these people are coming from, it's inexplicable. Well, if you just hold that in your mind, arm up, arm down, naked from the waist up, and then Bill Clinton's covered in a piece of cloth, well, this is where it's coming from. This is the ancient depiction of the compilation of the negative force symbol that the Templars worshipped, or high-level Templars worshipped anyway, called Baphomet. And this is why that they depicted George Washington.
Yes, we can. Thank you, Satan. 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 Thank you, Satan.
Freemasonry goes so far as to actually call Lucifer God. In the words of Sovereign Pontiff of Universal Freemasonry, Albert Pike, yes, Lucifer is God, and unfortunately, Adonai, the Hebrew God of the Bible, is also God, and the true and pure philosophical religion is the belief in Lucifer, the equal of Adonai, but Lucifer, God of light and God of good, is struggling for humanity against Adonai, the God of darkness and evil.